Alright, hello. Today we're going to be making some pixel art. I like pixel art because it's really fast to make. You can make a lot of pixel art in a short amount of time. It's really cheap to make. You can find a lot of free resources to make pixel art. I'm using Marmoset Hexels right now, but I used to use paint.net, which was free, and GIMP and Krita are also good resources to make pixel art on, which are also free. And it looks quite beautiful if you learn how to do it right. I'm no expert, but I've been playing with pixel art for a while. I started in order to make assets for video games, and I started just making standalone pieces eventually because I just like doing it and I think it looks pretty good. So I figured today I'd show you how I make pixel art in Marmoset Hexels. So if we move over into the canvas, I'll show you the first step. You're going to want to get a palette, right? So it's like winter, snowy season, and I'm thinking a lot about the snow. So I think I'm going to make an igloo today for you. I went ahead and I picked these colors, as you can see. You're going to want some like darker colors for the shadows and lighter colors for highlights and stuff. But you want a lot of like mid-range colors that you can just sort of dabble in, like the foundation and everything. So you can differentiate between like surfaces. Because when you're working with such a little space, you need color is going to be your best friend to define shapes and everything like that. So you're going to want a palette too, because when you get working with all sorts of different colors, you start to the canvas gets really cluttered and it isn't as pretty. It's kind of hard to look at. So, and restricting yourself, you become a little bit more creative than you thought you were. So. First step first is getting your palette. You can find a lot of them online and stuff, but it's pretty easy to make your own. Just kind of go through, get some shadows, get some highlights, and then throw them wherever. You can throw them on the side of here and then just grab the color off your canvas. But Marmoset Hexels has this nice palette tool built in. So anyways, moving on. Let's talk about the canvas, right? So this canvas here is 32 by 32 pixels. It's about that big. Like, there's a lot of room to make stuff in here, make a big smiley face, and that's very like legible. You can obviously tell that that is a smiley face. But when you start working with smaller canvases, the pixels, they're so big on the screen. It's important considering like what you do with this space, right? So now I'm making a smiley face. Look at, you have to really kind of think about the space that you're using. It looks kind of just weird, right? Like, you can't just so nonchalantly throw stuff in there, or else you'll have these like corners touching, and if you erase it, I mean, it looks fine, but it also looks kind of thin. So working with smaller canvases is more difficult. It can be faster in the long run if you're making a lot of things, but to start, you might want to use a bigger canvas. Oh, whoops. Let me get rid of this. Okay, there we go. So I'm going to work on 32 by 32, and we'll be making an igloo. So, and down here too, you've got your layers. You want to keep layers in the back of your mind at all time, because if you start drawing over something, it's going to be difficult to color or add detail without going over other layers. So, yeah, I've spent enough time talking. I'm just going to start drawing. So, you know, just go pick a color and start making some composition. You can watch what I do. It's really just put the pen to the paper and try some things, and what feels right will feel right, and you just sort of go ahead and do it. So I guess I'll just fast forward a little bit while I draw. Okay, so this is gonna be the basic outline, I think. A lot of indecision in what I'm drawing. That's okay though, because it's not, this is not the final product. You just want to get like a basic outline first. And if I took this grid off, you can see kind of looks like an igloo. Kind of looks like a polar bear, honestly, to me. That's what I'm seeing. But you know, just get the basic shape. Oops, didn't mean to do that. Get the basic shape, and then from there, throw some color on it and maybe detail a little bit. So I'll go ahead and do that, and I'll see you when that's done. Okay, so the igloo, I added some of these bricks here, as you can see, and I threw a chimney on it. I think we're gonna put some smoke on the igloo, and maybe I'll animate it too. So and here I'll go and turn off the pixel grid, and I mean, that kind of looks like an igloo to me. I might have to make this a little more defined, this side, but I'm gonna go ahead and do the ground around it, and then yeah, I'll just see where it goes from there. So I'll be back again. Okay, so this is what the igloo looks like now, right? I kind of threw some snow around it in a night sky with stars and some smoke in the chimney. I'm not totally sure how I feel about it. It feels like there's not enough contrast between the snow and the igloo, but I'm gonna go ahead and animate it real quick. Animate the smoke and the stars. If you weren't working in Marmoset and you wanted to animate something, it's pretty simple. You pretty much, there's a lot of animation softwares out there. Used to be Flash. Adobe Animate exists still though. And I'm pretty sure there's a lot of stuff on the web that you can just sort of throw keyframes into, and every second it'll loop over it. But I'm just gonna quickly animate the stars and the smoke really quick in Marmoset, and you can see sort of how I do it and apply it elsewhere if you don't have Marmoset. So I'm gonna go do that really quick, and I think that'll be the final product. Alright, welcome back. So the igloo is pretty much done. As you can see, there's like shadows and stuff. The campfire sort of blazes in the back, and the stars twinkle, and the campfire smokes, and there's a little shadow in the door that sort of reflects the fire inside. And I think I'd like to call it complete. As you can see, adding frames and animating it is really not that hard. Since I had those layers, I could change individual parts really easy. I mean, if I didn't layer it, it would be really tough, because I would delete this and then it would delete whatever's behind it. But with the layers, you can go in and manipulate pretty much any piece that you want, like the stars. And changing it too is pretty easy. I mean, look, this is 8 frames. I think it's like probably like 24 frames per second or something. I don't really know where I would find that, but I mean, this is literally like animation, right? I mean, like, people used to do like paper and they would just flip it in their hands. Even if you don't use Marmoset Hexels, you could throw this into any animation tool really easy, as long as you animate the different frames and the different components. It wouldn't be hard to make like a whole movie or something like this. And in my opinion, I think it came out pretty good. I did it kind of fast. I mean, it took me an hour about, but I'm really tired, to be honest. And I'm just trying to make something real quick to show you. But if I had sort of like a plan in mind and a storyboard, I mean, I don't see why you couldn't make a whole animation out of pixel art. And I think it looks pretty cool too. But I guess that's just because I made it right. So that's I think I'm just gonna wrap up my pixel art tutorial. I hope you learned something, and I hope you might go and try pixel art, because it's pretty fun, and it's pretty easy. So there's no reason that you can't do it. You don't have to animate it or anything. You could just make a still image. I mean, look at this. Look at this nice igloo. Like, you can have this and be happy with it, right? So I hope you learned something, and I hope you have a great day. Thanks for watching. Bye.